Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. And in today's video, you read the title already. We're going to do a nice, smoky, warmy, bronzy Indian glam. And you've been asking for like wedding looks since a while. So I thought I'll make one, but I've done a lot of looks before. And literally any look can be Indian, you guys. I feel makeup, of course, has a little bit changed here and there when it comes to Indian look or like a more festive wedding look. But I think different kind of accessories and outfit only kind of determines more of that wedding festive look. And makeup can be very versatile. You can wear it on Indian, you can wear it on Western, and you can just play around as much as you want. But that being said, we're going to do a super beautiful but super easy look. I kind of keep these things a little simple and a little versatile so that you can play around with these looks a lot more. Because it's wedding season, I know a lot of people are looking for buying few makeup products to glam for their special days or their friends' special days. So I wanted to give you a lot of affordable options which are available on Amazon. So every single product I have here is available on Amazon, and because it's wedding season, they have amazing offers going on as well. And like always, all the products will be linked in the description box. Now let's get started. So my skin is prepped in terms of skincare, and I'm just going to go in with a primer before we go in with foundation. And I'm using the Lakme Absolute Undercover Gel Primer. It's a proper silicone-y gel based one. It's good to just fill in those pores, especially like if you have like oily skin or large pores, this would be like really useful. It does not hydrate or do anything, but it does like create like a layer for the foundation to go on smoothly. So I'm going with the foundation which is a little matte because I do have oily skin. So if you're somebody who has a little dry skin, then you can probably use the Maybelline Fit Me, but I have oily skin and this foundation works pretty well for me. So I'm going in with the Kalbar 24 hour weightless liquid foundation, and I am in the shade FC 6.2. It on the back of my hand, just going to, it's a very thick consistency foundation. You'll feel like it's super super full coverage once you look at it, but once you blend it, just melts into the skin and you don't feel it's like too heavy. I again apply only on the cheeks part. I tell this always, apply only where it's necessary. You don't want to apply foundation where it's not necessary and make unnecessary cake on your face. You don't need that. Use as little product as you can and get that flawless finish. You can see just like those two dots kind of covered the entire area. This does oxidize a little bit, so it looks a little lighter now, but in like 5 minutes it'll match my skin tone very well. It's a very medium coverage foundation, so if you do have like discoloration etc, you have to like go in with a color corrector first and then go in with foundation. Now here, right here, I do have a little bore mark, so I'm just going to go and add a little more right in this spot because I can see my blemishes coming through a little bit. Whatever is left on the brush, I'm going to go ahead and add that on the forehead, so it does match my chest quite well. So next for concealer, I'm going in with the LA Girl Pro HD Concealer. I'm in the shade medium beige. I'm just going to go a little heavy on concealer because it's a wedding look. I want to look as awake and bright as possible. Next, for cheek tints, I've been obsessed. It just reminds me of, there are these things, right, when you kind of like glitch and then like glitch, they extended and then they make it a song. I can just think of that. Anyways, I'm so much into cream blushes these days. I cannot imagine doing makeup without it. So for a cream blush, I'm going in with the Rene Lip and Cheek Tint. It's one of my favorite lip and cheek tints. This is in the shade Red Romance, and I'm going to go a little warm on the eye as well because I have this like, you know, warmness going on my dress as well. Whenever you're going in with a cream blush or a cream contour, always warm it up on your hand. This way you will avoid it being patchy. Sometimes these things tend to dry down, so once you apply it, it kind of dries down. It's really hard for you to blend, right? So just take and just warm it up on the back of your hand, and that way once you like go tap in, just, you know, applies without any effort, and you don't have to like worry about it not being blend, and you'll have a lot of control of how much is going on. If you directly dunk in and just put it on your face, sometimes it'll be like Whoa, it's like I applied too much now. I don't know what to do. I mean, you can definitely blend it away, but it'll take you a lot more time and it'll not be under control. So this way, just you can apply as much as you want and be done. Always again tap on your concealer, tap on the area you want the coverage to be the most. So the coverage I want the most is in this area, so I'm going to tap there and blend it as much as I can before I move into another area. So just keep tapping, count numbers if you are a little impatient, and then blend the rest of it. The more you blend, the more beautiful your makeup is going to look. If you're not going to blend, if you want to do it like so quickly and you expect it to look really nice, it's not going to happen. You have to sacrifice. Sacrifice, basically spend a little more time, give it a little more time and do your makeup well. Just taking the whatever is left on the brush and not taking excess product. It's going to like kind of blend it into the concealer. Again, I'm going to take the foundation brush and blend everything together so that there's like no harsh edges anywhere. Okay, all blended. Look how nice it looks. There's flush of color on the face also. There's concealer, there's foundation, but you can't see like where one thing starts, where one thing ends. It has to look like a mixture of things, but you can't really identify where one starts and where one ends. I don't know why I'm repeating this so many times. I wanted to give like a really nice example, but I can't think of any. It should be like salt and water. Should be like sugar and water. It should be like Tata salt, basically, where everything mix very well. I don't know, man. Sorry, I'm not this lame generally. I'm not. Don't worry. Anyways, for powder, I'm going in with the Sugar Cosmetics Set the Tone Tinted Powder in the shade 30. Make sure there are no creases before you set the foundation because there is no use if you set it and there are creases, it's going to crease. If you don't know how to set your concealer to prevent it from creasing, I have a video entirely dedicated for that. It has been useful for so many people. You can definitely check that one out. I will leave the link here or in the description box. Make sure you powder your face well, especially for a wedding, because you'll dance, you'll roam around, you'll sweat a lot, you'll get oily, especially if you have oily skin. You've got to set that base, especially when you hug somebody, you make sure like you set it, or else like the entire dress of somebody. I have friends like they do their makeup, then they don't set it, and especially like when guys wear like white shirts or anything, like you hug them, literally face impression goes on to their shirts, poor things, and it's not good. Makeup does not come off their shirts again. Make sure you set it and then you can bring back the dewiness with highlighter and setting spray. So don't worry about that. Next, for bronzer, I'm going in with the Wet n Wild contouring palette. Going to take a fluffy brush, coat it, and add it on the high points. Can you see like the difference? This side I have the bronzer on. It just like lifts my cheekbones so much more compared to this side where I did not apply bronzer yet. I do have blush already, so it does have a little bit of lift, but you can clearly see the difference. I hope you can. At least I can see it. This is one of my favorite bronzers. You can clearly see I hit pan on it. So affordable, it blends beautifully. I love the shade on my skin tone as well. Next, we are going into blush, and for blush, I'm using the Swiss Beauty Ultra Blush Palette. I used this one in my recent Amazon, like inexpensive makeup trying on video. I'll link that video if you've not watched it. I found so many beautiful affordable options in that, and this was one. I really love the highlighters are okay, but the four blushes, oh my god, they blend so beautifully. And the colors, you have like various different options. You have like two pinks, two corals, which is bomb. So I'm just going to take this shade, going to dust off the excess, and I'm not going to add too much, like just a little bit. Blush, the thing is, I kind of go a little heavy on blush because blush is the first thing which kind of tends to fade away. So like a cream blush helps it to stay without it moving anywhere, and the powder blush is like kind of a topping for it. All right, so we have highlighter left, but let's add highlighter in the end. We'll move on to eyes, and for eyes, let's go in with brow pencil. And for brow pencil, Hilary Rhoda eyebrow pencil brush to my brows. I don't usually do a lot to my brows because you can see I have pretty thick, just that I have a little gap here, so all I do is like go there and fill it up. I don't do anything beyond that because little also more it kind of becomes too chunky. It'll literally be like two caterpillars are sitting on above my eyes, and that's not a good look. I've had those days before where I had to like draw so much and kind of equalize both the things. Add so much, you know, brow pencil, brow powder. They literally used to look like two blocks of brows, which was not a cute look at all. Then next I'm going again with the concealer. I'm just going to add that on the lid so that we have a proper base for the eyeshadow. Okay, for eyeshadow palette, I'm going in with the Swiss Beauty Ultimate Eyeshadow Palette. This is in number 6. First, I'm going in with the shade. I'm going to add that in the crease. Just the transition shade to kind of, you know, define my eye. I like when you don't know how to shape your eye or eyeshadow, kind of just look straight. Start, you know, pointing from here and kind of lift it on the edge. So I usually go with my transition shade from here and I lift it into my brow bone. I just like that lifted look. I don't get my eyeshadow down because it makes my eye droopy, and especially because I have this part here, it already makes my eyes look like, you know, that drooping. So what I do is I directly go into that shade, and especially for transition, I just, you know, blend this way. I don't blend it downwards. Of course, you know, I'll be adding more shades which will be here, this part, but this kind of defines where my eyes are, you know. Even if I'm not doing any eyeshadow or for my regular look, I just go into the bronzer and I do this. It just, you know, gives that definition to the eye and it looks really nice. See, now you know like how your eye is mapped. Next, I'm going to take this dark brown, like bricky brown kind of thing. Going to add that in the crease as well and deepen it up. I started working out yesterday after almost like 2 weeks, and I did upper body today, arms basically, and I'm not able to blend my eyeshadow. My hands are paining so much. Usually this is like a very normal thing for me to like blend my eyeshadow for at least like 5 minutes, and like I'm now doing it and my hand is so tired. It's paining so much. My body is so sore. So I was blending and I'm like, my hand is paining. I'm like, why is it paining so quickly? Then I realized I did arms today and oh my god, I'm in pain. Next, I'm going to go in with a little more deeper brown. I'm going to add that on the edge. Really nice, no? I love how the colors were built up. I was going to say how the colors were built. I'm like, I only built myself. How will I? Nobody else did. Please don't exit the video. Don't. So I added a little bit of concealer on the lids. My goal here is not to do like a cut crease, like a sharp, precise cut crease. I want it to be as effortless as possible, but adding concealer that kind of gives it a little definition, but also makes the pigment stick better and look a lot more pigmented. So that's the reason I added a teeny bit of concealer, because this has this, what do you say? I don't know what you call this, bristle kind of thing in the starting. It kind of makes it easier to just like directly go and apply rather than just using a brush and doing the entire like process. So for the shimmer shade, I'm just going to mix these two shades. I'm going to take my finger, just go in with the two shades and add that on the lid. I'm going to go in with a tiny brush and take the same shades on my lower lash line as well. So if you're a beginner, definitely do eyeshadow before you do your base so that you don't like have fallout or anything. I'm just used to doing it now. I cannot like do my foundation later. It's not a habit. Even if I think, okay, today I will not do it, And then by the time I sit and I start doing it, the first thing my hand goes to is foundation. Next for kajal, I'm going in with the Rene Holistic Kajal. Just going to add this as a eyeliner. Just going to... Using the kajal, I applied to wing it out. I'm just going to take this like almost black kind of brown and I'm going to set that kajal, because if you don't set it, usually kajals can transfer. For lashes, I'm going to go in with this Calais lash. I'm going to use the one in the bottom. For highlighter, I'm going in with this palette from Shion, brush through these two shades. Okay, I'm done with lips and unfortunately did not record, so I will just tell you what I put on. So for lip liner, I went in with the LA Girl lip liner in hazelnut, and on the lips I went in with the Lakme Absolute matte lip color in the shade Nude Sensation, and this is what I got. That is the finished look. I feel like I look like my mom with all the pearls and all. I'm wearing a chain. I feel like I look like her. But I love how the makeup turned out. It's so clean. I love when my makeup looks so good. The eyes, the base, I feel everything is so precise and beautiful. This is a look you can do on most of the Indian outfits for your wedding looks. And it's maybe just you wear like cool toned outfits, you can go with more cool toned looks. But just those 3-4 shadows, play around with them, and you'll get beautiful, stunning like eye looks. I really love how my eyes turned out, my base, everything. It just coordinates really well with everything. And I actually sat down, I pulled all these products out, but I had no idea what I'm supposed to do in terms of eyes, etc. But I really love what I did and I'm very impressed by myself. I love how everything looks. Again, each and every product I've used is available on Amazon for you to create your beautiful wedding guest or wedding look. All the products will be linked in the description box. If you like the video, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell and like and comment also. It helps my video to reach to more people and we can grow together. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.